Welcome to the 2023 Spring Music Festival at Appalachian Bible College. This evening, our program is entitled Water, Water Everywhere. Covering about 70% of the Earth's surface, water is mankind's most abundant natural resource and a basic necessity for life. From the beginning of recorded history, poets and artists, as well as composers and musicians, have been captivated and inspired by the dynamic quality of water. They have tried to depict its mysterious yet beautiful characteristics. In tonight's program, we want to share some songs about work and play, songs about the weather, and songs about love. All of this music has one thing in common, the image of water. We invite you to sit back and enjoy this water-themed extravaganza of art and music, Water, Water Everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Stephanie, is this a good place to do the laundry?
This looks like a great place for laundry.
What is happening? This is not a good place.
What are y'all doing here? Have fun.
Always fun.
What are you doing here? We're in the middle of the spring music festival. This is the third song.
I'm here to do his laundry because he told me this was a great place because there's water everywhere.
Not true. Thank you.
Skipping stones
with a twist of the wrist, I just gotta get the gist of skipping stones.
Toss it quick with a flick, cause I think that is the trick to win.
Ripple, 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 bounce, 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 watch it spin,
watch it spin,
watch it spin. To be great, so I need to concentrate on skipping stones. If I make no mistake, on the surface of the lake they'll rise.
Ripple, ripple, ripple,
bounce, 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 watch it glide,
watch it glide,
watch it glide, skipping stones.
Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there.
That's for sure.
Isn't that right, guys?
Yes. Look at this lady.
Let us tell you about it, man. Oh, yeah. Because you see, the seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. If you dream about going up there, that's just a big mistake. Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for?
Sing, 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 singing in the rain. Sing, sing, singing in the rain.
Sing, sing, sing,
sing, sing,
I'm singing
in the rain.
Sing,
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 singing in the rain.
Sing,
sing,
sing.
Rumbling roar, gathering on the horizon. Towering nimbus preparing to pour, gathering on the horizon. Winds blow, shaking the elements. Clouds roll over the sky. Rains fall, washing the earth as the storm rages on the horizon. Through the night, flashing in sight, running and racing, the storm takes flight. Through the night, flashing in sight, dashing and crashing till morning light. Thunder, lightning,
restless and relentless comes the tempest in a galloping fury.
Restless and relentless comes the tempest in a galloping fury.
Restless and relentless comes the tempest in a galloping fury.
Restless and relentless comes the tempest in a galloping fury.
Here in the distance a rumbling roar,
gathering on the horizon.
Towering nimbus preparing to pour,
gathering on the horizon.
Thank you. wider than a mile. I'm crossing you in style someday. Old dream maker, you heartbreaker, wherever you're going, I'm going your way. To drifters off to see the world, there's such a lot of world to see. We're after the same rainbow's end, waiting round the bend, my huckleberry friend. Moon River and me. Old dream maker, you heartbreaker, wherever you're going, I'm going your way. To drifters off to see the world, there's such a lot of world to see. The same rainbow's end, waiting round the bend, my huckleberry friend. Moon River.
There will now be a brief intermission. Please return to your seats when you see the lights flashing. Welcome back. Throughout the Bible, water is used to portray several spiritual truths. First, water demonstrates the enormity of God's power. In Genesis, God creates the vast oceans, sustains the tiniest creatures in the depths, and controls the weather, rain, snow, storms, and floods. He is all-powerful. Second, water illustrates the reality of God's cleansing. Titus 3:5 says, "He saved us by the washing of regeneration. To be saved is to experience God's cleansing from sin." Finally, water in the Bible is a metaphor for the safety of God's presence. The well-known 23rd Psalm says, "He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul." In the second half of our program, our prayer is that you will be encouraged. God is a good Father who calls you to experience the cleansing of salvation. God is a strong and powerful Father. The one who created the oceans knows the depths of your pain and the complexities of your life. He offers you the strength to persevere. Finally, God is a loving Father. He provides rest for the weary. He soothes the hurting and will one day provide his children a home in heaven.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. thirsty and weary of strife, come to the waters of grace.
All who are wounded and winded by life,
come to the waters of grace. All who are covered by dust from the day, Jesus is waiting to wash it away.
Come be refreshed as you learn to obey.
Come to the waters of grace.
Come to the waters of grace. In the fountains that flow from above,
Season and all. At the river where bright angel feet have trod, with its crystal tide forever flowing by the throne of God.
the beautiful river.
Well, do you have any questions about what the focus of tonight was about? I wonder how many times the word water was said through the course of the evening. It's been a great evening, and thank you for sharing it with us. We know that this is a special weekend that has lots going, but you've shared your evening with us tonight, and so thank you so much for doing that. And I'm so thankful for all the hard work that you've displayed or seen displayed tonight with all the preparations and all that has been involved with it. I think a round of applause again, if you'd let me just invite you to do that, I think worth it, so thanks. And I wouldn't be fair if I didn't acknowledge the hard work and leadership of Mr. Jeremy Yao, the chair of our music department and the music faculty that worked with him and just preparing this together tonight. I know that lots and lots of effort goes into that. How about a round of applause for those folk and what they've done? So I appreciate that. I know that this is an evening that we also are happy to share with you folk that have joined us from the community, but I hope you'll take note of things that are available you can continue to share with us as you see in your program tonight, some of those future opportunities, and I trust that you'll take advantage of them. It's a privilege to share our campus with guests from our community, and you that have joined us tonight are special. I also want to say that you'll take note of that big word, big, there. We're so thrilled that we have the privilege to announce that we are now offering for incoming new students this fall, whether they're transfer students or first-time college students, a provision that will care for their entire tuition. And I hope you'll spread that word wide and broad. Our purpose is not simply to just attract students, but to truly seek to nurture them to be founded upon the Word of God. Our world needs Jesus. Do you agree? And if you don't agree, you're wrong. How's that for bluntness, huh? Our world needs Jesus, and we believe that young people need to be grounded in the Scriptures. And so we have found ourselves saying, we're going to put our money where our mouth is and ask God to just bring those to our campus that we can nurture to love and serve God in the midst of a world that needs Jesus. And so spread that word, and I trust that'll be an encouragement to you tonight. I'm going to ask the students to move down into the audience to greet you. And as they're moving, I hope that you'll find yourself just rejoicing in the privilege of sharing this evening with us. But I also hope that you'll find yourself just reflecting upon the wonderful, wonderful occasion that we move for tomorrow as we observe the Resurrection Sunday. I know that that event in our calendar is not just an event, it is the cornerstone of our faith. And I praise God for a resurrected Lord. Tonight, as we've talked about water, been references of water in different ways, but I must confess that probably one of the most famous and certainly one of my favorite passages in the Scripture that deals with water is that occasion where Jesus encounters a lady that was desperately in need, not just of physical water, but of spiritual water. It's the woman at the well in John chapter 4. And as you know that account, she came at a time of the day which was not normal for getting water, but her reputation, her circumstances of ignominy had been such that she found herself having to get water when nobody else would come. But that was the day that Jesus was there. And as Jesus met her there, he encounters a lady that was not just thirsty for physical water, but desperately needed spiritual thirst satisfied. And as he discussed that need with her and confronted her with that, we have these words of Scripture that I'd like to leave in your hearts as you depart tonight. Jesus says to this lady, "Whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again." And dear friend, tonight, I don't know each of your hearts, and so I say without any apology, if your only satisfaction is this world's water, it will never satisfy. I'm not talking about physical drinking. Jesus was using the imagery of water to let it be known that if our only gratification is what this world offers, we're always thirsty. If you're only searching after stuff, advancing your own interests, only having a concern for yourself, material things, any number of lists we could make, they'll not satisfy. They'll not satisfy. But Jesus goes on to say, whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst. Jesus promised something that he still promises to you tonight. The water of life, the water of eternal life that only Jesus can offer. Dear friend, if you've never trusted Jesus Christ as your Savior, if you're honest, your soul's thirsty. You're looking for something to satisfy. And I say without any apology, but with great gratitude to God, Jesus is the satisfaction of that thirst. And so he says, the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. This isn't just a drink for tonight. It is an eternal, lasting, satisfying drink. If you've never trusted Jesus, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, the risen Lord, and be saved. And the thirst of your soul will be forever satisfied. So tonight, I hope that will be the reminders you've enjoyed this evening with us. We've talked a lot about water, had some fun, had some interesting moments. But above all, I hope you'll remember, Jesus said he was the water to satisfy your soul's needs. Would you stand with me, please, and let's thank him for that. And I trust that if there's a need that's registered in your heart as a result of these moments, that you'll not leave this place thirsty, but you'll find your soul filled with the water that only he can give. Let's pause in prayer. Lord, thank you so much for the privilege to be your child. And we know that's because of the privilege of taking that water that you give, not in a sense of a drink from a fountain of this earth, but it's from the source of your very giving eternal life to us through your precious Son. We thank you for the living water. And I pray tonight if there's any person present, or any person in the sound of my voice that may be viewing this or listening, may they tonight know with certainty that they have indeed taken a drink of the water of life that only you can provide. Thank you for our friends who've gathered, and ask the blessing upon each of us as we go our separate ways. May we truly give this water to those around us, and may we enjoy the satisfying drink of the water of life that you give to us. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. I'm Dan Anderson, president of Appalachian Bible College. For you that are guests tonight, thank you for joining our campus. I trust that as you leave, you'll find your heart refreshed. And I trust also as you gather in the Lord's house tomorrow and celebrate the risen Lord, that you'll remember he is indeed the living water. God bless you. Good night.